Today we're going to talk about how to cycle TB-500 and BPC-157. And so we'll dive into some of the main reasons why people use these peptides. And hopefully by the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to cycle these peptides, how to keep it safe, because a lot of these peptides, they are not FDA approved to treat medical conditions. So this is not medical advice. This is simply sharing very insightful expertise from what we've seen in working with 70,000 clients. The very first thing is, let's talk about BPC-157. What is it? This is a phenomenal peptide because if you look at this structure, it's 15 amino acids and it's derived from human gastric juice. And that means that every cell in your body, it was discovered out of the University of Croatia, I believe it was around 1992, and they were looking for this single molecule that had panacea properties. Now, I'm not calling this a panacea, but it's one of the closest peptides that I've seen that helps everything get better. And what they realized is they said, wow, this peptide, there's a receptor on every cell for BPC-157. And they started looking at its application. They said it's made by the stomach, therefore it must treat gastric conditions. So they looked at it for gastritis and colitis and even Crohn's, and they said, oh, this seems to be really powerful in the animal models. And then they damaged the Achilles tendon on a rabbit, and they used BPC-157, and that rabbit healed about 3 times faster than the control group did. So they summarized, like, wow, this is a very powerful molecule. And now, you know, biohackers, bodybuilders, and longevity centers, we've really brought this out and used, you know, thousands of these prescriptions of BPC-157 and TB-500 for over a decade, and we've seen phenomenal outcomes. And the problem is, I see a lot of doctors, because they'll say, this is a really good peptide, and they put the patient on it. I've asked the patient, I'm like, well, when was the last time you cycled off? And they'll scratch their head and they'll say, oh, it's probably been a couple years. Well, think of the law of entropy. So, you know, when that boulder's rolling down the hill, it stops at the path of least resistance. And that's what happens to our body. If you just keep pulsing these receptors, then the body doesn't get a chance to make it on its own. Now, it's different than the feedback loop that you'd get from using like testosterone or a hormone, but there needs to be some subtle shifts in cycling that occurs. And this can happen if you're somebody who loves to use it on a regular basis like I do. One of the things I like to do is just take one day off per week. It's pretty simple. And that seems to be enough to reset the receptors, where I always notice an improvement when I use BPC and thymosin beta 4. I do take, I'll go 90 days and then I'll take about 2 weeks off to a month. And that's another way you can cycle this. Once again, it's when you're using peptides, you want to consider the input biologically. You want that to be as small as possible. And we're still learning so much about these peptides. It's also very safe for your future. And we don't want to do anything that would risk your future health. So thymosin beta 4, this is another phenomenal peptide. It's made by your thymus gland. What the research shows is it promotes cell migration. So if you need cells to help repair an injured tissue, if you have immune cells, for example, it helps those cells migrate to the place of the body that's been attacked. It works on actin dynamics and angiogenesis in wound healing. So what that means is you actually have less scar tissue that builds up over the wounds, so it heals more naturally when you have thymosin beta 4. And a lot of times with wounds, we'll combine BPC-157, thymosin beta 4, KPV and LL37. And you'll see the skin just has a dramatic improvement. We've had a couple of clients who've had injuries from laser treatments on their face. And we've used that protocol, had them apply GHK copper to their skin, and then had them do the injections of those four peptides, the TB-500, BPC-157, KPV and LL37. And literally they heal dramatically faster. And so this is another thing that it does, is when you have a cut, thymosin beta 4 or TB-500 is the first active peptide that mobilizes stem cells into that area that's been damaged. So if you think of, you know, like inflammation in our arteries and blood vessels, well, it's the TB-4 that actually calls stem cells into action. So you have more reparative properties in that damaged blood vessel. So if you drink alcohol, if you went and partied the night before, you're gonna have a lot of inflammation the next day, and you probably felt it. Thymosin beta 4 can be one of the safest peptides you can use to help mitigate some of the damage in your liver, your kidneys, and also the blood vessels. I'll tell you the safest way is just like don't drink alcohol. That will get rid of the problem altogether. But think of this core fundamentals of these two peptides, the Wolverine stack, two of my favorite peptides in the whole peptide universe. Number one, you're going to get more nitric oxide production. And nitric oxide is something that's so key because it's a gas that sends signaling to every system in your body. It allows for better oxygenation, your blood vessels dilate, you get more oxytocin, so you feel more connected to people, you get more confidence, and nitric oxide gives you a massive boost in your endurance and cardiovascular function. So if you've ran your blood labs and you look at your carbon dioxide totals, if they're not between 25 and 30, especially if they're too low, then there's a good chance that something like thymosin beta 4 and BPC-157 could be really good for you. And the best way, if you're cycling these, you want to make sure, like, what are your goals? So let's just say that your goal is, I want to have really healthy brain function. Okay, that's a great goal. So what you want to do is use this peptide 6 days out of the week, and you want to be doing about 25 units, which ends up being about 0.3 milligrams every single day, and then take a day off. And it's ideal, take a day where you do protein fasting, you do more of a caloric restriction on that day, and that's a good day where you do recovery, reflection, do a lot of like Qigong, Pilates, yoga, things like that. And that's a really good cycle. And what you'll notice, especially when you go in that fasted state, your brain will just create this nice level of clarity that you've never had before. I like adding in exogenous ketones, and these exogenous ketones allow my brain just to use a different fuel source on those days that I'm fasting. So for those of you who have an injury, which is this is the majority of people who are using this peptide, there's been hundreds of times, probably thousands in the course of my career, where I've had an injury and I've just injected it into that place. And I'm like, man, that was a pretty bad accident on my mountain bike or snowboard or whatever. And so I inject it and I'm like, ah, I feel pretty good. I see that same thing with hundreds, if not thousands, of my clients. And it's really fun to see. So if you have an injury and it's like a severe injury, you want to go up to a milligram per day. And you want to do that every day for about 60 days. And it's a very high dose, but it will get you the results you're looking for. If you can add in like regenerative medicine, like stem cells or exosomes, that can change everything because it changes the cell signaling. For those of you who have digestive issues related to autoimmunity, here's how you cycle it. The very first thing you want to do if you have this digestive issue, well, do a stool test so you can make sure there's no infections. And this is where you want to remove the infectious agent while you're doing TB4 and BPC-157. What these peptides do is they help seal up that tight gap junction, and that allows the inflammation to get reduced in the gut. And ideally, you want to take it oral. If you have blood in your stools or if you're losing weight substantially, make sure you see a GI doctor. Don't risk anything. It could be something really severe going on, or you could be bleeding out. If you're extremely anemic, make sure you look at your labs before you start cycling peptides and self-diagnosing. It's really important to work with a functional medicine team. Just go to agelessfuture.com. But here's how you cycle it. The very first thing is, if you're trying to calm down the autoimmune response, you want to start on a very small dose. If you start on the highest dose, like 1 milligram per day, you could actually create more of a cytokine storm. It may just trigger your immune system. So what you want to do is start on 0.3 milligrams and do that 5 days out of the week and then take 2 days off. And if you're very sensitive to things, you have pretty severe autoimmunity, you do 1 day at a very small dose. Usually it's about 10 units. And then you wait 3 days and you do it again, wait 3 days and do it again. And then you can start going every day and it will change everything. And then as your body gets more resilient and you start seeing that inflammation come down, you're not reactive to everything. Someone walks in the room with perfume on and you can still stand upright. You know what I'm talking about. If you experience this kind of autoimmunity or mycotoxin illness or biotoxin illness, you'll start to scale it up as you feel better. So there's whole protocols around how to cycle this based on your condition. But generally speaking, if you have an acute injury, you need that tissue to heal, you're an athlete, or you're just somebody like me who loves moving their body and being outside a couple hours a day, moving, that's where you want to start, like 1 milligram a day, and do that for maybe 2 weeks, and then you can start cutting it back. If it's a real severe injury, you may need to do it up to 60 days. Make sure that you're giving your body a break every 90 days. 90 days, every day in a row, that's kind of the maximum. We don't know enough yet to know how long you can use this safely. I've been using it 12 years, never had any issues with it. I check my labs about every 60 to 90 days. That doesn't mean that it's safe for you, so make sure you work with the medical team. If you love this video, share it with your friends, family, loved ones, and I've provided a gift for you. Look at the link below and you'll see my peptide blueprint book, and that will give you even more insights on how to transform your health. I'll see you in the next video.